President Trump is moving ahead with selecting a Supreme Court justice. He tweeted Wednesday morning, "I will be making my Supreme Court pick on Thursday of next week. Thank you." If confirmed, his nominee will fill the vacancy on the high court created after the death of Justice Antonin Scalia almost 1 year ago. CBS News chief legal correspondent Jan Crawford joins us now from Washington. So, Jan, you've been reporting on this extensively. We know the president has narrowed down his choices to three top contenders. Who are they, and what do we know about them?
Well, the front runner right now is a federal appeals court judge. He's based out of Denver, named Neil Gorsuch. And, you know, he is an establishment guy. He was a former D.C. lawyer, elite prep school education. He went to Columbia, Harvard, Oxford. And he just sailed through his confirmation hearings to the federal appeals court. But I am hearing from a lot of my sources that this is coming as a real disappointment to conservatives who had urged Trump to put another federal appeals court judge on that bench at the Supreme Court, the Alabama-based William Pryor, who is a well-known, highly respected judge who has kind of weathered some of the storms and held firm and not, you know, kind of watered down his views. And I think that really, at the end of the day, is what kind of cut against Pryor. He was filibustered at his nomination by Democrats, and Senate Republicans, sources tell me, warned the White House that they were worried about a fight this time if he were the nominee for the Supreme Court. So that has kind of made now Gorsuch emerge as the front runner. The fight has seemed to be less for him. And a third candidate, a Pennsylvania-based federal appeals court judge named Tom Hardiman. He also is considered a conservative, but unlike Pryor, not as much is known about Gorsuch or Hardiman and whether or not they are, you know, a solid conservative like Justice Scalia, who was, of course, a conservative icon, one of the most conservative justices on that court. And that's why you're seeing this disappointment among conservatives, because this will not change the balance of the court. But if President Trump is to nominate a justice who turns out to be more liberal than, say, Justice Scalia, he will have turned the Supreme Court to the left.
Well, of course, it has been nearly a year since the death of Justice Scalia, and Republicans never even granted a hearing for Merrick Garland, President Obama's pick, to fill the seat. How would you expect Democrats then to respond to a nomination by President Trump, given what you just spelled out about the possibilities that the candidate may not be as conservative, perhaps, as other picks?
You know, Elaine, I do not think it will matter. Democrats have signaled that they are going to fight whoever President Trump sends up that's a conservative. We've seen Chuck Schumer say that as long as it's a mainstream nominee with bipartisan support, you're not going to find that nominee if you're a Republican president. So I think you're going to see a fight regardless of who the nominee is. Republicans are already talking about whether or not they're going to kind of trigger what's called the nuclear option. That's what they call it here. And they would do away with the filibuster rule for Supreme Court justices so that a justice could be confirmed with a majority of Senate votes. Now, Democrats, of course, did away with the filibuster for other presidential appointments, cabinet-level appointments, but they kept it in place for the Supreme Court. Republicans say that if the roles were reversed, Democrats would do away with it immediately, just as they may. And they also say that, you know, if the roles were reversed last year, Democrats never would have confirmed a third nominee during an election year if a Republican had been in the White House. So it's kind of like, you know, the Hatfields and the McCoys here, these judicial confirmation fights where the Democrats and Republicans are always locked in. But this battle is going to be, I think, enormous. Although I got to say, the next fight, when President Trump, I think, will get another appointment, if not this year, then next year, that's going to be, you know, gloves off fight right there.
Yeah, that was going to be my next question then. So you believe President Trump could get a second nomination during his first term?
Yeah, he will. I fully expect that he will. Justice Anthony Kennedy has kind of long been contemplating retirement. He, of course, was nominated by President Reagan, but he was a huge disappointment to conservatives because he ended up voting with liberals on a whole host of social issues and other issues. Obviously, he's refused to overturn Roe versus Wade. He voted to that the Constitution protected same-sex marriage. He's refused to end affirmative action. A lot of the social issues that conservatives really care about. about. He's been a liberal vote. So if President Trump does get that nomination, as I expect that he will, that's when you'll see a fight, because Democrats will say, well, this nomination is actually going to change the court. And that's what I think is so interesting about the Scalia fight. You know, that's not going to change the balance of the court. There were only two justices on the court who would have voted to overturn Roe versus Wade, and one of them was Justice Scalia. So right now, the only other one is Justice Thomas. Roe versus Wade is not in play. Very difficult decision, I think, for any of the justices to overturn at this point, because it's been on the books for so long.
All right. Both sides, though, digging in, likely. All right. Jan Crawford in Washington. Jan, thanks so much. Appreciate it.
Sure. Thank you, Elaine.